everyone. Welcome. Can everyone hear me okay? We're running a new kind of sound being outdoors this year. It's totally different. Welcome. Thank you for coming to our 10th annual Spooktacular concert. I didn't realize this was the 10th until the other day, and I was doing the math. I started in 2012, and it's 2021. This is the 10th time. So this concert began my first year at Paris. After about a month or so into the school year, I was telling my assistant principal at the time how I really wanted to do a spooky themed concert with costumes someday, but it's just so hard at the beginning of the school year to pull such a thing off. And I'll never forget what she said. She said, just do it right now. Like, now is the best time to do it. And I'm so grateful she encouraged me, because it quickly became my favorite concert of the entire year. And even though it is such a quick turnaround, it really is a lot of fun. This year, I was very tempted to skip this concert again because of all the restrictions and the obstacles that we had to go through to pull it off. But back in my head, I still heard Miss Maron going, just do it, now's the perfect time. And I was thinking about it. The more I thought about it, now is the perfect time. My eighth grade students have gone almost 2 years without a concert. Seventh grade students have never done a band concert with me. Sixth grade students never done a band concert either. I think not only do they need it, but I also need this. I think as a musician, this is probably the longest I've ever gone without doing a concert before. I think maybe a couple weeks or a month is the longest I've ever gone without performing between gigs and shows. And a full year went by, and with these guys, almost 2 years. There's really nothing quite like the excitement and thrill of performing live in front of an audience. And I'm sure that's a big part, but a big reason why I got hooked into performing. And I think our students will get their first taste tonight, and this might change some of their lives as well. Many students you're about to hear just started to learn to play an instrument just 2 months ago. At Paris, we're pretty unique in that we have six different band classes. Until this year, we've never had a beginning level band. We've always been very fortunate in having an amazing fifth grade band program, which usually feeds me over 100 incoming musicians. Since our current sixth graders did not get that opportunity last year, we're making up for it now by providing two different beginning bands, concert band in front of you now and symphonic band, which is next. This is the first time I've ever taught an entire class of beginners since I moved to this district, and I'm so proud of how fast they've been learning. And it's pretty remarkable if you think 2 months ago they didn't know how to read a note on the page, and now they're all doing a concert in front of you right now. It's pretty impressive. You might hear some big squeaks, fracked notes tonight. In fact, I guarantee you will. That is a big part of the learning process, and it's going to be really fun to track their progress over the next year. You guys will get to hear it firsthand as you come to our winter concert and our spring concert. You'll hardly recognize them by the end of the school year. Before we get started, I want to once again thank all of you guys for being a part of tonight and for investing in your students' music education. It's such a really important part of their development. I'd also like to thank our supportive administrators, Principal Dr. Erickson and Ms. Vermose, along with the district board and our superintendent, Dr. Stephen Keller. We're gonna start our concert tonight with one of our beginning band's concert band. They're gonna start with just one song. It's called Conquest. Our concert band. How about one more round of applause for our awesome concert band? They did great. They didn't look nervous at all. Give us just 1 minute. We're going to have our symphonic band come up, and we'll start with their warm-up in just 1 minute. Also just learned to play their instruments this year as well. This is our symphonic band. We meet during first period, which is the easiest period of the day because it's not hot yet. If you compare the tanness of all the students, you can tell which period they're in. They're first period, there's no sun. Seventh period concert band you just saw, they're in the elements every day of them. The good thing is when they get to be old and they have kids and grandkids, they can say, well, when I was a kid, we had to do our band outside in the rain and the sun, but it's good for them. They're getting really strong from it. All right, so this is our symphonic band. They're just gonna play one piece as well. This one is called G-Force 5. The symphonic band. How about one big round of applause? That sounds great. wind ensemble. It's made up of mostly sixth graders. There's a couple seventh graders. What makes this band different is most of these students all took private lessons and started learning an instrument on their own last year. Some through private teachers and a lot through Sunset Learning Academy. How many of you guys took private lessons or took some kind of lessons last year? Raise your hand. Don't be shy. Okay, good. Yep, so coming in, these students have a lot of experience already, and I've been really blown away. This is the first time I've had a band of this many students who took private lessons, and they're doing outstanding. Let's see. So we're going to start, they're going to play two songs tonight. We're going to start with a simple one called Creature Feature. And Georgia for our program notes at the beginning. Great job, Wind Ensemble. So last year I was lucky enough to be assigned a co-teacher during our distance learning. This teacher spent years teaching fifth grade band before the previous year, but due to the restrictions, he was temporarily assigned to co-teach with me in Paris. It was a true pleasure spending so much time with him last year, and he helped me in so many ways as we try to come up with creative and fun ways to teach and inspire our band students to keep practicing their instruments through all of this downtime. If you watched any of our virtual band concerts, you might have recognized him. He's the one with all the exquisite acting skills that he was showing off in the film. I really appreciate all the hard work he did. He invested so much time into our program, and I just feel really bad that he never got a chance to truly perform with us. He was on our virtual concerts, but he never got to rehearse the band or conduct the bands in concert. A lot of these students that are coming up right now are in seventh grade. So he worked with them last year in sixth grade at Paris, but he also worked with them in fifth grade the year before the restrictions set in. So he's been teaching some of these students for over 2 years. So I thought it'd be very fitting to have him back on our first concert. So let's have him come up here. He's gonna be conducting the next two songs of our Wind Symphony. Mr. Buchan, come on up. He did ask me to call him Mr. B tonight because of his costume.
No one is safe. Those nasty dust bunnies are seeking their revenge. And there's only one person who can save us, or can be.
Thank you.
another round of applause. What about those drums? Hey, one more round of applause for Mr. Buchan and all his work last year. He was really helpful. I really wish I had him this year. It would be so much fun having him now that we're back, but not gonna happen. All right, so we have just two more groups and then we're all done. So next up will be our Chamber Ones group, and they're coming up right now. Advanced band along with jazz band, which is why they get the longest warm-up. They have the hardest music. The warm-up actually goes on for another couple minutes, but I think they're ready. What do you guys think of the outdoor concert? I think I might like this better than indoors, actually. It's kind of nice, right? I think we should all take a minute and be grateful to be in California, because I don't think they're doing this in Wisconsin right now, probably. So this is our Chamber Ones. Every student in here had to audition to get into this band at the end of last year. This year there's about 30-something students in this band, and we always put a maximum of 40 just to keep it kind of small. They're going to start with a song from one of my favorite movie composers, Danny Elfman. This is a little medley of some of his movie music. This is called Danny Elfman, Music in the Dark. Thank you. right, we're going to go to our next song. This one is Highlights from Harry Potter. One more song with chamber winds, and we're going to have our jazz band join us too, just for fun. So we're going to do a combined piece. This song, when we started playing, it reminded me of something kind of interesting. 5 years ago today was the most stressful day of my life. We did a spooktacular right inside there. My wife was 1 week late with our first daughter, who's a fairy princess tonight. And then we did the concert, went home, went to bed, and like an hour later, she goes, "Wake up, time to go to the hospital." And I said, "All right, here we go." So we went to the hospital. And then there she is. That was a crazy night. Now she's here now. We're telling her her birthday's tomorrow. Don't tell her, because Daddy's been a little busy today. Tomorrow we're going to celebrate. But this song reminds me of her, too, also, because she hasn't had a true chance to trick or treat yet. So this is going to be the year. We didn't do it last year, and before that she was kind of young. So she's pretty excited, and even her little sister now is already talking about candy all the time. So it's very difficult, but they'll like this song. This song is called "I Want Candy."
Thank you.
Thank you, Chamber Winds. How about one more big applause for Chamber Winds? Great job, Chamber Winds. So this is our jazz band. Just like the Chamber Winds, this is an audition-only group. And mostly 8th graders as well. Equally advanced. Younger students tonight will get to see what they want to do someday, if they want to do the more concert style, which is Chamber Winds, or more jazz style, very good jazz band. We're going to start off with a song called Big Cat Groove, which is going to feature two improvised solos. For Kyle Smith and Meredith Bucker. Great solos, guys. Very good. All right, this next one's a weird one, I admit. I did an arrangement of a TV show that some students are watching, but they really shouldn't. This is the theme song. It's kind of odd. This is the theme song to a show called Rick and Morty. Thank you. All right, it's Mark on piano over there. Great job, Mark. That's a little solo. Jasmine has one more song for you guys tonight. This is by one of my favorite all-time musicians. This is Superstition by Stevie Wonder. Encore piece for you that's kind of fun, and we had 20 minutes during tutorial to practice it today, and it works. I think it's going to work tonight. We're going to have all 200 people stand up and play Thriller here, so if you're feeling it, do the Thriller dance in the middle somewhere, okay? This will be a fun one.
Thank you.
big round of applause for everyone tonight. They've been outstanding. Very proud of you. Great job, everyone. All right. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe, and we'll see you guys at the winter concert. Take care.